I want to.
Why is this so hard to talk about?
Okay, here we go. Totally unscripted. I, for the first time in my bass playing career, have an injury. Have something wrong with my first finger, my index finger on the right hand, really sort of important digit when it comes to being a bass player, as I'm sure you're all well aware. It is something that the reason I'm filming in front of this total mess, I just moved house, moving into a new studio, is because the mess has contributed to said injury. I even have a prop here somewhere. Despite having professional movers come and do the bulk of the move, the big stuff, the bed, the couches, the stuff I was really just never gonna even attempt to lift, there were close to 100 of these boxes, and because our new house is on 3 floors, street level is right there on the very top floor. My studio here is all the way down at the bottom, so everything had to come down 2 flights of stairs. Most of the stuff in my studio also had to come up a flight of stairs to street level in the old house. And what I didn't realize is, despite the fact that I keep myself in very good physical shape, I like to exercise, I like to stretch, I like to do all that stuff on a very regular basis, what I didn't realize is in carrying all these boxes through these side handles, that the first finger on each hand, and it's manifested itself on the right hand more than anything, maybe I was pulling more with that, is that a lot of the load goes to the side of the first finger there. And over time, the hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of times over the course of 3 or 4 days that I picked up and put down boxes and carried them up and downstairs, I gave myself some kind of strain in the first finger on my right hand, my picking hand. And in this video, I want to talk about how I'm managing it, how it's been to be on the road since moving. I actually had to go out and play immediately after I finished moving, how I haven't practiced in several weeks. And also, I want to tell you what I'm doing to get over it, to manage the injury and to make sure I'm repairing the damaged, maybe that's tissue, tendon. I guess a big disclaimer here is I am not a physician, I'm not a physical therapist, I'm not accredited or qualified in any official way, shape or form. So everything you see or hear in this video is all anecdotal. It's not something I'm saying you should try, but it's what is working for me and is helping me get better. And it's both scary and weird to talk about because it's the first time anything like this has happened in over 30 years of playing the bass. So it's quite a shock mentally to the system. And I'll explain a little bit about how I found out that it was injured, you know, after the 3 intense days of moving the trucks and the lifting and all the stuff I just chronicled, I finally got a few hours sleep. And when I woke up that 4th morning, I basically couldn't take my hand from this position and straighten. Oh, it's still a little bit tender now, actually. I couldn't completely straighten the finger at all. I sort of stopped right about there, couldn't get it straight at all, and really didn't have much mobility in it either. Now, I haven't been to a doctor, I haven't had anything officially diagnosed. I'm going on my many years of training as an athlete, as a kid, my many years now of training as at a professional level of athleticism when it comes to tennis, my year on the ATP tour with the Bryan brothers, working alongside some of the best physical therapists and those gurus of the body with the ATP, and just all the people I've surrounded myself over the years that know a lot about this, kind of assimilating all that knowledge and putting the recovery into practice in my own little way. I'm also limited on time. I'm in and out on the road all the time right now, and I just don't actually have time to stop and go through a whole process of getting it diagnosed. So this is what I'm doing. And I'm actually drawing a lot upon a few things I picked up when I had a huge obsession with cards and with card magic that I got from Jojo Meyer, from being on the road with him. I've been doing it for almost 20 years now. It's continued to be an obsession. I don't get to the cards as much as I would like, but a few of the exercises and a few of the stretching moves from that world for the dexterity of the fingers, for the control that you need in order to perform prestidigitation, card magic, close-up magic with coins and that kind of stuff. Been taking a bunch of those exercises. I don't know why I haven't talked about them more on the channel as it relates to bass, because I've used these throughout my career to great success, and all of these preventative exercises have worked really well. Now I'm using them in reverse. I'm using them as rehab and using them as kind of a barometer to gauge where my flexibility is at. I'll show you a couple of them right now by putting the hands together like this, matching all the fingers and the thumbs. I go down the fingers like this, probably do that 8 to 10 times, just going in and out, and then switch. So this is good for building some strength, building some dexterity, some independence. Again, like I said, it's been mainly preventative for so many years and has worked to treat. Oh yeah, there we go. Okay. Not great when I get to the first finger. And amazingly, like I said before, it's only on the right hand. So at least it wasn't both sides. But this slowly over the past 10 days now, will be almost 2 weeks since this happened, doing this every day. And it didn't take long. It felt a bit tender at the beginning of filming here, but it didn't take long to move the hands and get some blood flowing into them. So they're functional. It was when I transferred them to the base that I was a little more scared and a little more frightened about how bad the damage was and how potentially long term it might be in terms of coming back to full strength. We'll get to that in just a second. I'm going to do some playing. I'm going to highlight what I'm doing with the base specifically. But these basic exercises have been fantastic. Let me give you a little side view there. Just even on a dexterity level, if you don't have an injury, try doing these. It takes a little bit of getting used to. Like I said, I do them like 8 to 10 times on each finger. And I might do that, do sort of 3 sets of that as a little bit of a warm up. Other things that I've come across speaking to other musicians, actually some classical musicians, some classical guitarists that I know well and really respect, in terms of some wrist stretches, because like everything is connected. My understanding of it is that everything's connected. So even if the issue is here in the finger, working all the way through the arm, making sure the entire frame of the body is loose and has flexibility and full range of motion is useful for really fixing the tiny element of the injury all the way at the finger. So I do some wrist stretches, which are just useful anyway, no matter what. In fact, I'll take my watch off so you can see both hands here. I'll take the hands straight and then I'll bend them forwards to 90 degrees, bend the wrist to 90 degrees. And I'll normally wait there about 20 to 30 seconds. And if it starts to hurt, like my rule of thumb is if anything starts to hurt, I stop immediately and reset. But this is actually quite comfortable now. You feel a little bit of warmth in the wrists. They start to warm up and then relax, even shake them out a little bit. And then I'll wait 10 or 15 seconds and I'll go into the opposite. I'll straighten out the arms again and then pull them back 90 degrees. And the same thing again, like 20 to 30 seconds, start to feel the burn coming in a little bit. It's not really burning, it's just warming up a bit, feeling the stretch, and I'm feeling it in my forearms as well. It's not just the wrist, I'm feeling it all around the lower parts of my arms. And then relax and stretch out. So those are a couple of things that, like I said, were always preventative, something I've always done throughout my career. Now they are helping me recover from this situation with my first finger. Let's take a look at what I'm doing specifically with the bass, because today was the first time I actually sat down with the instrument to practice. And I'm moving house, I'm moving into this studio. As you can see, it's chaos behind me. There are boxes everywhere. Don't even know where all of my other basses are. I would have loved to have grabbed a 4-string actually and toned it down even more, gone more simple. But seeing as I had to go out on the road the day after I started noticing pain here, I'm playing this bass, I'm playing that kind of music, pretty intense music. I had to start troubleshooting that right away. So it was a lot of working on the exercises. It was a lot of like things like drinking water and making sure I was hydrated and getting, making sure joints and everything were working and doing as much work on that as I could, from the very basics, things you can do literally anywhere. You have access to water, you have access to your own limbs to stretch. You can make it happen pretty much anywhere. That was my immediate troubleshoot. That was how I went about it to try and get through those 6 nights on the road in the Midwest. And now I get to sort of dial back and see exactly where my hands are and what I need to work on and focus in. The injury is over here on my picking hand. Focus in on that first finger, right hand. So I'm going really simple. As always, I try and grab something out of one of these books. These are exercises that I've used for so much of my career. I'm taking one of the grooves, one of the play-alongs from Bass Player's Guide to Pentatonics, and instead of actually working on one of the exercises in the book, I'm just using it as a starting point to feel out where my fingers are at, where the injury is, and how much I can play now that I've had a few days off after the tour. Now I'm sort of reintegrating myself into the process of practicing. It's kind of a hidden bonus of all of these books because they all come with so many play-alongs. You can repurpose the play-alongs even harmonically speaking. I'm going to show you how in just a second with this groove in D flat. It's sort of a little Easter egg that I don't think gets talked about enough. I don't think I mention it enough. And I think if you have one of these books, you should be aware of it because you can get so much more out of it. You don't just have to stick to what's on the page. By the way, I do have a ton of physical copies of these and all of my books are here that I will sign and ship worldwide. They're all linked below. If you want to grab the play-alongs, they all come with play-alongs, with videos, the whole thing, tab, standard notation, you name it. They're all linked below. You can pick up copies of this here, physical ones that I'll sign, send worldwide. You can also get them on Amazon. You can get digital copies at my website, janekgwizdala.com. And I want to show you what I'm doing with this. Really, it's just a static D-flat major groove. And I'm just feeling out my playing. Now, I'm forcing the sixth chord there, the minor. The chord hasn't changed, the voicing is still the same, and it really is forcing it because I think when I was making the keyboard parts for that, there's like a B flat in, there's a D flat, sorry, there's a root in there. But it's high enough up in the register that when you play the B flat below it all, it sounds like B flat minor. And you can do all these other diatonic chord motions using that one chord in the play along to the point where I'm getting, like I said, D flat major. Down to the sixth chord. To the four chord. Five. Really, what I want to do for the purpose of this exercise is hang out just on one chord. I was looking for something simple. I knew there was, it's 10 minutes and 24 seconds of that groove in every key. I'm looking at the whole play-along library here for Bass Player's Guide to Pentatonics, and there's every key, there's 10 minutes of groove like that. So you really can. I mean, I never intended the Pentatonics book to be a physical recovery mode from an injury, but boy, is it kind of useful in this situation. And I'm not playing hard with the right hand. I'm really being, it's the intent with which I'm playing that is really important. I'm not laying in, I'm not overplaying. I'm actually trying to do the least amount of work possible to see where my ceiling is. And of course, I'm going to push myself at some point. I'm going to try and play harder. I'm going to try and play more dense material. I'm going to try and play busier to see where, you know, to see where my range is and to see where my ability is. Hey, there's also one down here. I've just dipped the camera a little bit. There's also one down here for independence that we can do on the desk. I've done this since I was a little kid. Like, if I learned this maybe when I was 5 or 6 years old, for no reason connected to music at all. It just seemed like a fun trick at the time. But over the years, in terms of independence, dexterity, and flexibility, it has kind of really helped as a warm-up. And it's something, you know, I was doing it on the back of the seat in front of me in the van we were traveling in, for instance. It's something you can do anywhere there's a little edge. You can even do it in the air, I guess. And I'll show you all the various permutations of it. So we do outer fingers to middle fingers on both hands, just back and forth. And maybe you want some structure to how you, oh, I'm kind of out of the frame there. I've got to dip down here. I did dip the camera. So maybe you want some structure. You want to do this. Okay, we're going to do it 10 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Now switch. So we have opposite. So we have outer fingers on the right hand, inner fingers on the left hand, and go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and rest. And you know, I interlock my fingers sometimes and give them, it's not tight, that I'm not really pushing hard or pulling hard, it's pretty loose, but I'll interlock the fingers and give them that kind of action and then just shake them out. And then why not go again? It's a great little exercise. Now you can also, haven't done this in a while, you can do little finger, middle finger, and then ring finger and index finger. So maybe this is quite a piano specific one, although I wouldn't imagine you're pulling your fingers back and forth this much. It would just be like that, very delicately in position. But this gives you a little more range of motion, get some blood flowing in the fingers. I think I've used it as a warm up for almost 30 years since I've been playing bass. It's a great way to get some blood moving in the fingers. So can you do that on both hands? Oh, I think the answer is no right now for me. I haven't done this in a while. But that's yet another one to get more flexibility, more independence. Let's return the camera to its original position. Okay, so that's my little story about what's going on right now with the injury. I wanted to share it with you. I think it's important to be aware of it. It was a lot harder for me to like just hit record and start talking about it, and I don't know why. It was really scary when it first happened. Thankfully, it was less serious than I thought, and everything seems to be progressing as I hoped it would in terms of its recovery. I did make it through those 6 nights on the road. I have taken a break from playing for now 6 days since I've been home, and I'm back practicing a little bit, and more importantly than practicing, trying to recover from this injury and, you know, sort of documenting the progress and the process, and hoping to learn from it in the future. And that little, whatever it is, a strain or a sprain or a pull or however it would be technically categorized, it happened without me really realizing it in the moment. Maybe it was just a case of not stretching it enough right afterwards, you know, doing a super heavy set of squats or something and then not stretching your legs and wondering why your hamstrings and your quads feel like shit for 3 days. Could well have been that, and that is totally on me. Just in the chaos of it all, I didn't think about it. Hopefully by watching this video, you will be way more conscious of it. You'll learn from my mistake and hopefully leave here understanding a few things, at least ergonomically, about the hands and how they pertain to playing bass. Maybe you want to dig deeper into some of the exercises in Bass Player's Guide for Pentatonics or any of the books in my collection. Actually, it's a little Easter egg, and for those people who are real fans of the channel and watch the end of the video, this is the little PSA for you guys, because I get this question so often in the comments, in my email, like everywhere. Hey, you have all these books, I think I have 21 books out, where do I start? Like, there's no clear path, there's no like book 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I always end up replying that probably the best place to start is actually Bass Player's Guide to Pentatonics, because it has so much of an arc from beginner to pro, and the fact that it comes with all of those play-alongs, it comes with the option to work on the basics and to work on music and bass playing regardless of the style you play, whether you're a jazz musician or a metal musician or a country musician. The way I try and guide you to practice with great intent, I think, is useful across the board. So my answer to that question, if you've ever asked it, is always Bass Player's Guide to Pentatonics. I think a very close second, maybe if you're more jazz inclined, it could even be your first choice, would be Jazz Vocabulary for Electric Bass 251. Again, the 251, one of the most common cadences, chord progressions in modern music. I think no matter what music you play, just working on chord tones and the fundamentals and basics of harmony could really do you a lot of good as both a musician and a bass player. It has for me for the past 30 years. So these are the two that I always recommend. Signed copies, of course, available below. Copies at Amazon, digital copies at my website. They all come with play-alongs, with videos. Really appreciate you hanging out with me, spending some time talking about music, some of your really precious time talking about music, talking about the bass, and yeah, more to come on the injury. Hopefully this is the last I have to report on it, and see you all soon.